epidural stimulation program has grown into three areas of focus. And people don't really, I think, understand that spinal cord injury isn't just about motor paralysis, just not being able to walk. It's so many other secondary consequences. And so we're organized into three areas: movement, cardiovascular and respiratory, which is, you know, your heart and breathing, and then also bowel, bladder, and sexual function. Because after a spinal cord injury, you lose all of those things. So serendipitously, we learned from the courageous men and women who agreed to have epidural stimulators put in as pioneers that epidural stimulation actually positively affected all those areas. Epidural stimulation system is comprised of an electrode that lies in the lower part of the spinal cord. And we spend a lot of time choosing where that spot is because we want to be right where a specific network is. We've been able to use that stimulator and get the spinal cord back into a state where it can respond to the environment like it used to, and from tiny, tiny remaining signals that are still crossing the injury level. Then the other thing that we've discovered is how the human spinal cord is also the integrator of communication of all your other systems. It talks to your heart and your gut and your bowel and your bladder. So what we've been able to do with the stimulator is kind of, not the same way, but get the communication going again.
After being hit by a car in my driveway and being paralyzed from the neck down, I had no idea what to do, where to go, what type of therapy options were out there, what type of research was out there. And that's when my family and I started searching around the world to try and find what we considered the best therapy and research available for spinal cord injuries. And that's when I met Dr. Susie Harkema. And come December 7th, 2009, I was the first human in the world to receive the epidural stimulator, which is a small computer in my lower back with 16 electrodes on my lower spinal cord. By the third day of turning it on, I stood independently for the first time in over 4 years. So instead of it taking 2-3 hours every morning to get ready to go into therapy or go do something or to go on a date, it is taking me 45 minutes and be able to live a much more normal life. And the epidural stimulator has been able to give me all those things back. Things that once upon a time were only a dream or a wish have become a reality here in Louisville, and it's because of the epidural stimulator.
One, two, three.
My mom, she was riding this old horse at the time, and she said, "Stephanie, you need to get out here." And I was really resistant to going back out because I said, "Mom, it will never be the same as it used to be." And she went over to the horse, she put a halter on it, and she took the lead rope, she dumped it in my lap, and she left me. And she said, "Stephanie, go meet us on the upper pasture." And I was like, "No, I can't do that." And then all of a sudden it kind of clicked and I just started to do it again. And that was the beginning for horses for me, because I realized just because I'm different than how I used to be when I knew how to do this, I didn't have to avoid it. And I could continue to be in love with everything that I loved before. And carriage driving made sense. We were never open to that world before. I could say, "Stephanie, you can be an equestrian. You can go up and put your hand on the worlds and put your hand on basically the Olympics for carriage driving," which is what I said. And people looked at me like I was crazy. And we found out a way and approved it with USEF, the United States Equestrian Federation, for me to, I made up these cuffs that I put on my wrists and they attached these carabiners along the reins, and I mastered it. And then as I started moving forward, they started considering me within a few years as a potential equestrian that could represent the United States team abroad. And I was winning. I'm still winning. After we had a very successful show, the judge came back. He got on the back and he's just crying and crying, saying, "We doubted you, and you are gonna go very far. My life has changed with the epidural stimulator because we've been able to regulate my blood pressure." So I went pretty immediately from passing out 6 times a day to not passing out.
Your body doesn't know what to do anymore when you're broken, you know what I'm saying? Some signals are going through, some signals are still there, you know? So it's like, part of this research is stimulating those signals and pathways and trying to get them to work again. But it's things that you're hopeful for, because it's like, wow, my body can do these things. When can I translate it to, you know, like real life? Gives you hope of walking again and improving standing and doing functional things like get on the couch or, you know, just simple little things that you don't think about. So it's just quality of life is definitely, you know, gone through the roof from what it used to be.
I always leave their view of how our program affects their lives to them. But I can tell you that they certainly have brought a lot of joy to my life.